else could be?
Thancred. It could be Thancred. We must hurry.
This day, we reclaim the reins of history. This day, we rid ourselves of the Ascians forever!
Fools playing at heroes, all of you. Is this how you believe you can save your world?
We can and we will, Ascian. You shall see. Or perhaps you will not!
So you are the Warrior of Light, the savior of Eorzea. It's a wonder you didn't come sooner, what with the Primal and all. Lost a step, have we?
Have care. The ether moves strangely around him.
It would seem we share a common enemy. Mayhap you would tell us who you are.
Shall we show them?
Not very sporting of you to interrupt, but so be it. Mark well our faces, Warrior of Light, for we are the Warriors of Darkness, walkers of a different path.
and we shall meet again.
Warriors of Darkness? Really?
Tancred! Are you all right?
Pleasantries can wait. I'd rather not be here when the Nath arrive. Agreed?
Suffice it to say, our reunion was not at all as I pictured it. Waiting until the last instant to join the fray. 'Tis plain you have not lost your appetite for the dramatic.
My appetite for the dramatic? Have you forgotten the circumstances of our parting? The heroic last stand, the tunnel filling with light, and then... Had I known you intended to use forbidden magics to deliver me to some god's forsaken wilderness, I would have thanked you in advance.
Tancred.
If nothing else, you might have warned me that I would emerge from the life stream in the altogether. Eventually, I managed to fashion knives from some obsidian I found, and set about hunting for meat and hides. Given that I'm not all that skilled in leatherworking, it's probably for the best that I met the Vath before I was reunited with you.
So you?
A description which fit me as ill as the skins themselves. Happily, I was able to trade with the Vath for garments better becoming a man of refinement. From them, I learned of Ravana, and of the great warrior who had once laid him low.
And thence did you conclude that were you to track the Primal's movements, it would surely bring you into contact with the Scions once more.
It seemed a reasonable assumption. I could think of no one else with your enthusiasm for slaying beastmen gods. Until now, that is.
Ah, yes. The self-proclaimed Warriors of Darkness. 'Tis only fitting that they stand in opposition to the Warrior of Light, I suppose.
I glimpsed the leader's past, if only for a moment. They were confronting a man in black. An Ascian, I think.
If these warriors are capable of doing battle with Ascians and Primals both, they must be possessed of powerful protection. Protection not unlike the Echo.
Even as the Scions celebrated the return of a long-lost friend, honorable men plotted to deprive them of another. Honorable men, to whom Sir Emeric was no hero, but a scheming patricide. Honorable men, who would fain wash the paving stones of foundation with the tyrant's blood. Honorable men, whose knife in the dark was the spark which set the city aflame, and who sang as it burned.
Thank you. I do not mean to diminish our accomplishments, but until we identify the ones who ordered the fires set, our work is far from finished.
Between the various conservative and religious factions in Ishgard, I dare say there's no shortage of parties who would like to see the status quo preserved. Do any likely suspects spring to mind?
Far too many to count.
Lord Commander, your wounds
are healing well, thank you. Time is of the essence. Lest we forget, these men would sooner put their own city to the torch than see it change. When our enemies learn that we have apprehended their arsonist, there is no telling how they will react.
Lord Commander, an armed mob has seized control of the vault.
And now we know. Tell us what happened, sir. Spare no detail.
We were directing refugees into the Basilica, as you ordered, when all of a sudden, men brandishing weapons were all around us. It happened so fast, my lord. We had no time to respond. They've taken the refugees hostage and barricaded themselves inside the vault.
And they sent you to deliver their demands.
They, the true brothers of the faith, demand that a conclave to select the next archbishop be held forthwith. Furthermore, they declare that you, Lord Commander, are guilty of patricide and high treason, and that you must surrender yourself at once to receive of the Fury's judgment.
Ridiculous! Do they honestly think that executing Sir Emeric would change anything? That the truth will somehow die with him?
These fundamentalists rage against the passing of the old ways, unable to accept there can be no going back.
Given the fanciful nature of their demands, a peaceful resolution does not seem likely. If the hostages are to be rescued, it will be by force, I fear.
Agreed. Lucia, take a contingent of knights and establish a perimeter outside the entrance.
At once, Lord Commander.
Hilda, I need your people out in force throughout the Broom. When word spreads of the situation, the friends and family of the hostages may try to take matters into their own hands. I will not give these militants more targets. I shall lead the assault on the vault. Master Alfano, can I count on the support of the Scions?
Of course.
We are in your debt.
I shall join you as well, Lord Commander.
Your assistance is most welcome, Lord Atwarel. To arms, then, friends. Time is against us.
There!
With you.
Thank you.
You underestimate me!